Our story takes place one day in the life of Gerald, whose wife Helen has recently passed away. We see him enjoying a little TV recreation as he relaxes on the couch in his well-appointed living room. You're not going to believe what happens, so enjoy the show.
Well, I just wanted to see the news.
Don't tell me you've become a secret TV watcher.
I wanted to see the news.
Well, they're hardly likely to mention it on that.
No, of course not. It's old news now anyway.
You always watch the television together, that's what I meant.
Yeah, but your mother's not here anymore.
Exactly. And you can't watch it on your own.
Not ever?
Well, not quite so soon after.
Why not?
She's not watching it.
Well, she might be for all we know.
Anyway, what would the neighbors say? We only buried Mommy a week ago, and already you're watching the television?
It was only the news. I wasn't watching CSI or anything like that.
Don't you see? You were doing it on your own.
I haven't much choice, have I?
You're supposed to be grieving.
I am grieving. That doesn't mean I can't keep up with what's going on in the world.
Mommy would expect you to be grieving.
No, she wouldn't.
How do you know?
She told me.
When?
What does it matter when? Did you bring the evening paper home? Oh, thank you. Certainly you're going to allow me to read this, right?
When?
When? What?
When did Mommy tell you that she wouldn't expect you to grieve?
Oh, 3 weeks ago.
2 weeks before she died.
Hey, at school you never used to be good at math. What's going on?
What day was it?
I can't remember.
She was making this important statement about the possible nature of your grieving, and you can't remember the day?
I can remember the day, just not the name of the day.
All right, what did she say then?
When?
3 weeks ago, on an apparently unmemorable day of the week.
It was memorable.
But you forgot.
No, it was memorable for what she said, not for the name of the day.
Go on then, what did she say?
She said, and you may find this a little bit difficult to believe,
she said that if she went first.
That's right. What else did she say?
Make it sound as if she was going to the theater.
If she predeceased me, she didn't want me to grieve.
Mother said that?
Yes, I told you.
She said you weren't to grieve?
Yes.
Not ever?
Well, not to excess.
And you think a week is excessive?
I'm only telling you what she said. You seem to have done a lot of shopping here. What's going on?
I'm going to cook you a lovely big dinner tonight. Don't you like the idea?
I shall probably be grieving.
You can grieve and eat at the same time.
Well, I'm not very hungry.
Of course you are. How can you be expected to eat at a time like this? I'm sorry, Daddy. It was thoughtless of me.
No. It's just that I had a double hamburger at lunchtime.
A double hamburger?
Yeah, with French fries and a green salad.
How could you?
Well, I was hungry then.
You were eating a double hamburger a week after Mommy's funeral? What will people think?
She told me to. 3 weeks ago.
On the same day that she talked about grieving. I don't believe you.
You can ask her. Oh, no, of course you can't.
Mommy would never say a thing like that. Hamburgers in public after her funeral.
Not immediately after. I mean, I didn't go right there from the cemetery. If I'd known you were going to be cross-examining me, I would have had to put it in writing.
And I think that vest is a bit lively a week after burying your wife.
You think so, huh?
You haven't been on the lakes, have you?
What do you expect me to wear? Sackcloth and ashes? Anyway, I promised Helen not to wear dark colors.
When? 3 weeks ago?
Right.
You must have been very surprised all these requests when she wasn't expected to die.
Of course she was expecting to die.
She told you that?
No, but we had both retired. And after retiring, death's the only definite thing left on the agenda.
Daddy, did she make any other requests? Join the local tennis club, something like that?
Of course not.
I'm very surprised. She seems to have spent a lot of time compiling her list of post-funeral promises.
Well, I did the same.
You mean you gave Mommy a similar list of requests in case you went first?
Yeah, we were having one of those conversations. You know how it is.
No, I don't.
Oh, no, of course you don't. Elderly conversations, wanting to leave everything tidy conversations.
Like a prenuptial agreement?
Yeah, only this was a pre-probate agreement.
But how would you know which of your agreements was going to apply?
First past the finish line.
Is everything okay?
Everything's fine.
I heard you laughing.
Well, I'll try to do it again.
Hello, darling.
Hello, Shirley. Hi, Jerry.
Hi, Mom. Did you have a good day?
Oh, what?
I said, did you have a good day at the office? You've been at the office all day, haven't you?
Oh, yes.
Good man. So, did you?
What?
Have a good day.
Oh, yes. Quite good. Did you? Oh, I'm sorry. How could you at a time like this?
Oh, it wasn't a bad day, actually.
Really? Oh, great then.
I walked around the lake.
Well done. Around the lake.
It wasn't very difficult.
Well, I think it was very brave of you.
Well, it's not peopled by sharks, you know. A few Canada geese, that's all. And they're not too dangerous.
Okay, well, you're putting on a brave front, Jerry.
I've done it before.
Well, I think I'll go into the kitchen.
Yeah, it's right through there. You can see pots and pans and a sink and a refrigerator.
Daddy, I know where it is. Mark and I have been living here for 10 days.
Yes, of course you have.
What are you cooking tonight?
I'm cooking a big dinner tonight.
Are you? Is she?
Anyway, you want to talk, don't you?
Do I?
I'll see you later then, Daddy.
I expect I'll still be here.
A big dinner. A big dinner, eh?
Sounds like it. And she did seem to be heavily laden.
Can I get you a drink, Jack?
No, I'll do it. It's still my house, isn't it?
Yes, of course.
Second here.
Good whiskey. Be a nice relief for you, huh?
Mm-hmm. Water?
No thanks. See anyone you know?
Where?
Walking around the lake.
Oh no, the local widows haven't started gambling yet.
Sorry?
Never mind, that was meant to be a joke.
Oh, yeah, that's funny. Widows, yeah.
Take your
whiskey. Thanks.
Nuts?
No, I'm not very good with nuts.
Really? I don't mind, you don't mind if I have some, do you?
No, go right ahead.
You don't object to nuts as such, do you?
No.
Because they don't bother me, you see. I can usually handle my nuts quite well. Well, here's to your mother-in-law. The one in the cemetery.
Oh, oh, right. To my mother-in-law.
Oh, isn't that bad that you grew up?
Good heavens, I almost forgot.
What?
I got something for you.
What is it?
It's some sort of a present.
It's not my birthday, is it? I don't think I'm up for two big occasions in one week.
No, I thought you might like this.
You mean there's more than one of them, whatever it is?
I certainly hope so.
Thanks. Shall I open it now?
Yes, you can if you like. Unless you want to open it in the bedroom.
Is it something you use in the bedroom?
No, I thought you might prefer to open them in secret.
You mean you don't want me to open it here?
Well, okay, you can.
Right, I will then.
She won't be back for a while.
Who?
My wife.
Shirley?
I don't have another one. She's in the kitchen.
I know, she's sitting to dinner.
So you can have plenty of time.
She's a slow cook, huh?
Well, you know, Shirley does have to consult a cookbook occasionally.
All right.
So you should have plenty of time, sir.
Well, it won't take me very long to open this package.
I didn't mean that.
Doesn't Shirley like to see people opening packages?
It depends what's in it.
I see. What is in it?
I can't tell you, it's a surprise.
It certainly is. A surprise and a secret, apparently. A secret from Shirley, that is, right?
Well, she doesn't know about it, so yes.
And you don't want her to know about it?
It might be better.
For her not to know about it?
Yes, she might take it as an insult.
Oh dear, I'd better open it then. And if you hear Shirley coming, give me the nod and I'll hide whatever it is under the sofa.
Right.
Sandwiches!
Explode, you know?
Who'd expect them to explode? They're sandwiches.
Yeah, smoked salmon.
Smoked salmon sandwiches?
Yes, on brown bread.
All right.
You do like smoked salmon sandwiches, don't you?
Oh, yes, especially on brown bread.
So I thought it would be a nice surprise.
It is, and it's the first time.
Sorry?
Nobody's ever given me a present of smoked salmon sandwiches before.
Really?
Not that I can remember anyway. It's quite a new departure.
I did the right thing then?
You certainly did.
Great. Well, go on, try it.
You mean I've got to eat them now?
That was the idea. I thought you would be dying for them. I didn't know what to say. I thought you'd be longing for them.
That's all right, Mom. It was a very nice thought. Fancy you being at work, busy on your laptop, and suddenly comes to mind, I'll take the old man some smoked salmon sandwiches and brown bread. He'll be longing for that. It's just that I can't understand why.
Why?
Yeah.
Well, you said you like smoked salmon sandwiches.
Yes, I do.
So why do you ask why?
Because I don't understand why you did it.
Ah, yes. Well, I see. But, you know, poor old Shirley.
What?
Well, you see, she means well in the kitchen department, but let's face it, Jerry, she's a pretty poor cook.
Well, I didn't want to.
Well, she is.
Yeah, I know, but...
So I thought after 10 days of Shirley's cooking that you would like something really different and something you really like.
Oh, that's what you meant about not insulting her. You didn't want Shirley to know about the...
The smoked salmon sandwiches.
That's all right. It can be our little secret.
Exactly.
It was very considerate of you, Mark. I do appreciate it.
Well, get on with them then.
All right. Let's see here.
Are they okay?
Very nice. Very nice indeed. Better than that risotto last night, right?
Yes.
That's right. And?
You know, the reason I'm not eating them is, even though they're very, very nice, I'm not very hungry.
Oh, of course you're not. How could you be hungry at a time like this? I mean, it was bound to put you off your food a bit, right? Losing your wife like that?
Well, it's not like losing her at Costco or anything.
No, but it's bound to affect you somewhat.
It wasn't that, though.
You mean the fact that your wife died? Oh, I didn't mean to say dying.
Well, it's not just that.
Then what?
Well, at lunchtime, I had a double hamburger on the plate.
A double hamburger?
Yes.
In the bar?
Yes, with French fries and a green salad.
Everything's under control. Sorted out then?
Oh yes, we got everything sorted out. Didn't we, Jerry?
Yes, we did.
You're both looking very furtive.
No. We never look furtive when we're having a drink.
Yes, you do.
Well, no, you better have one then. And you won't notice then.
Well,
Jerry, give her a drink.
You'd better have one. What would you like?
Oh, sherry, please.
Okay.
So how long will it take, you think, to cook that?
Oh, a while. You know me.
Well, we need a while, obviously.
No, it needs to be cooked back there.
Can we get you a drink?
Surely, Sherry, yes, indeed. Thank you, Daddy.
Did you ask him?
So, Daddy, what did you think of the arrangement?
What arrangement?
Mark, I thought you two had been talking.
We did. We have. Haven't we?
Good. So, what do you think of it?
Think of what?
You said you'd been talking.
Yeah, we were. We went, your dad went for a walk.
I know we
Around the lake.
I know we went for a walk.
Twice, actually.
Yes, he told me.
Yeah, once this way and once that way.
You must have worked up quite an appetite then.
No.
Well, I shall be very disappointed if you don't do justice to my cooking. I've made an extra effort tonight.
Oh, good.
And as a special treat, we're going to have smoked salmon for starters.
Smoked salmon?
Yes.
With brown bread?
If you like.
Well, that's what you usually have with smoked salmon, isn't it, Mark?
Yeah. Yes, it certainly is.
You do like smoked salmon, don't you?
Oh, yes, we like smoked salmon, don't we, Mom?
Yes, especially on ground bread.
Oh, good.
Was there something you were supposed to talk to me about?
No, I don't think so.
Yes, there was. He was supposed to tell you about the plans we've made.
India! You're going to India.
No.
You've always talked about going there, but I never thought you would do it.
We're not. No, we're not.
Not going to India?
No.
On a cruise?
We're not going anywhere.
Oh dear, what a pity. What plans were you talking about then?
Plans for you, of course.
For me? I don't think I got any plans, not now that Ellen's gone, not yet anyhow.
Daddy, you can't stay in this house.
It's not settling, is it?
Mark?
Shirley's right, Jerry. You can't stay here on your own.
But I live here.
Yes, yes, I know you live here, Jerry.
Well, Helen and I were married here, and this is our home.
That's why you can't stay here. You wouldn't like it anymore. That Helen's dead, you wouldn't like it anymore. I didn't mean to say that, I'm sorry.
So then, what are you suggesting?
We want you to move in with us.
With you?
With Mark and me and the boys.
You're joking, aren't you?
Of course we're not joking. We'd like you to live with us, wouldn't we, Mark?
Yes, of course we would.
Well, I wouldn't.
Daddy, why not?
Well, for one thing, you never make lists.
Lists?
Yeah.
What sort of lists?
Housekeeping lists. What things you're running out of, flour, sugar, that sort of thing. Your mother was a great list maker. I could never live in a house without lists.
Well, I could start making lists.
No, no, you never keep it up. If you haven't made lists by your age, you're not going to start.
And that's all that's stopping you coming to live with us?
Well, it's not just that.
Not just lists?
No.
What else then?
Well, Mark, you haven't started oiling your garden tools, have you?
No, that's one of my blind spots.
Well, I mean, consider, what if I got up one day and wanted to go out in the garden and putter around, and I went into the garden shed, and I would find that your rake is all covered with rust. You should really take good care of your equipment, you know. I always take care of my equipment.
Can oil mine.
Oh, no, that wouldn't do. I mean, he has to take care of his own tools.
So you don't want to come and live with us just because I don't make lists and Mark doesn't oil his tools?
You wouldn't like me living with you. I would drive you mad in no time. I'd be in the way. The boys would hate it.
No, they wouldn't.
Listen, grandfather should only be taken out twice a year. Once on Christmas and once for birthday.
Now listen, you get on well with the boys. You can talk sports to them. You know all about football and basketball, and you always watch the America's Cup.
Yes, they love it.
It's not them I'm thinking about.
Oh, but you're my father, and you're all alone, and I want you to live with me and my family.
Well, that's very sweet of you, Shirley, and I do appreciate it. But this is my home, Helen's and mine, and we want to go on living here.
But she's not here anymore.
Yes, she is. Of course she is. She's over here. She's upstairs. She's downstairs.
Daddy, that's just a photograph.
I know, but she's here as well. All over. I can talk to her while I'm doing the dusting.
Hey, Jerry. If you go around starting to talk to pictures, they'll take you away in a straitjacket.
That'll solve the problem, won't it?
You're not expecting anyone, are you?
No, but life is full of surprises.
Perhaps it's the pastor.
You're not expecting the pastor.
Certainly not. I saw him last week.
Did you really?
You remember? He was at Helen's funeral. He was the one who was all dressed up and did all the talking.
was Aunt Amanda.
Aunt Amanda? My sister-in-law?
Jerry, 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 I'm so sorry.
Oh, there's no need to apologize.
I wasn't apologizing, Jerry. I was expressing sympathy.
Oh, yes, right. Oh, thank you.
Why should I be apologizing? I'm not late, am I?
Just a bit, yeah.
The funeral is tomorrow, isn't it?
No, last Saturday.
Last Saturday?
Yes.
But I was in Tanzania. I couldn't possibly have been here last Saturday.
Well, I'm sorry. Helen couldn't wait for you.
Are you sure?
Yes, definitely last Saturday.
Well, why didn't you wait for me?
Well, we had already booked the pastor.
Oh, dear, and I went and bought these lovely, lovely lilies.
Very appropriate.
They're lovely. Must have cost you a fortune.
Yes, as a matter of fact, they did. Well, I suppose you should have them then, Shirley.
No, no, I couldn't.
Oh, well, they're no good to her now. Mark, 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 Mark.
Hi.
I'm so sorry.
What?
I'm so sorry. On such a sad occasion. Was it really last week?
I'm afraid it was.
I don't understand it. Helen knew I was going to Tanzania, mind you. I did wonder when I saw Jerry in that weird vest. Go and put these in water for me, good boy. We don't want them to wilt, do
no.
we?
No. Not when you paid so much for me.
Always knew he had a weird sense of humor.
Yeah.
Oh, Jerry, I really am so sorry for being late. What would Helen have thought?
I don't expect she would have been surprised.
Jerry, that's very unfair.
Well, you always were forgetful.
But my own sister's funeral? And I should have been here to look after you.
That's all right. Shirley and Mark have been staying with me.
Oh, well, I'm sure they must have been a great comfort. Oh, that's such a lovely, lovely picture of Helen.
Yes, it is.
She was the perfect sister and wife. You poor man, you must miss her dreadfully. Still, you're drinking. That's a good sign.
Would you like a drink, Amanda?
Oh, what a good idea. It's been such a long day.
Perhaps
and
she
I'm
can.
I'm quite help. Exhausted.
Perhaps she can help yourself. Here's the whiskey. Touch the glass.
Please pour it for me, Jerry. I don't pour my own drink.
Certainly. Water?
Don't be silly, Jerry.
Here we are. How's that?
I say, I've got a wonderful, wonderful idea. I'm so mortified by getting the date mixed up that I'm going to make it up to you all. I'm going to take you all out to dinner. Champagne, the lot. We'll have a proper celebration.
It was a funeral, Aunt Amanda, not a wedding.
Whiskey.
A celebration of her life. That's what I meant. Oh, thank you, Jerry. Well, here's to...
No. Don't bother with that. We've done it all.
Sorry?
Helen, Mommy, Mother-in-law, we've done a lot.
How about late... Sister,
don't be flippant, Shirley. It doesn't suit you. That isn't the whiskey you usually have.
No, it isn't.
You usually have malt.
Yeah, but I'm cutting down now that I'm a widower.
I wondered why you offered me water. So, dinner tonight then.
Well, actually, Shirley's already arranged to cook dinner.
She hasn't, has she?
I'm making a special effort.
Oh, dear.
I already put the flowers there, Charles.
Yes, there we are. They're lovely. Well done, darling.
So they should. Honestly, the price you pay for flowers these days. Mark, I was thinking of taking you all out to dinner tonight.
Oh, great. What a great idea. I'm starving. Aren't you, huh?
But apparently, Shirley's got it under control.
But it can wait, can't it? I mean, can't you hold it till tomorrow? No?
Another night?
What a good idea. But mind you, gonna have to be fast. Because, Jerry, you got something else on your mind, right?
So what I?
Yeah, you never told us, did you? You old dog. Your father's a dark horse, Shelley. Yeah.
An old dog and a dark horse.
What are you talking about, Mark?
Listen, for what it's worth, Jerry, I think you're making the right decision. The moment you told me you went walking around the lake, I knew that you were on the right track. So, we're all dying to know. Sorry, I didn't mean to say dying. We're all longing to know.
Longing to know what?
Which direction you going in, you old sea dog?
An old sea dog now?
Is Bermuda on your agenda?
Bermuda? Good Lord, no.
Well, I hope it's not one of those AARP cruises. They're all old people there. You wouldn't like that.
I'm not going anywhere.
You're not?
No, I never gave you that idea.
I saw two suitcases by the door.
Well, they're not mine.
No, they're mine.
Yours?
Yes, of course.
Ah, you're on the way to the airport.
No, Jerry, I've just come from the airport.
Yes, but tomorrow you're off again. That's it, right? An overnight stop and then another one of your trips. I know you're an inveterate traveler.
No, Jerry, I've done enough traveling for a while. And now I'm going to settle down.
Then why have you brought two suitcases here?
Because I'm coming to stay, of course.
To stay?
Yes.
Here?
Yes.
Why?
Because this is where you live, Jerry.
Yeah, I know that.
Jerry, I think she means she's staying for tonight, and tomorrow she's leaving.
No, she doesn't mean that.
She doesn't?
Certainly not.
Monday. You're staying for the weekend and going home on Monday.
Don't be silly, Jerry. If I was only coming for the weekend, I wouldn't have brought two suitcases, would I?
Right. So, why have you brought two suitcases then?
Because I promised Helen.
You promised Helen you'd give me your old suitcases?
They're not old suitcases. I wouldn't be seen dead with old suitcases.
Sorry, she didn't mean to say that.
I made a solemn promise to Helen that if anything happened to her, I'd look after you. We're having coffee in Starbucks. I remember it quite clearly.
You mean you were having one of those elderly conversations? One of those wanting to leave everything tidy conversations.
However, did you guess?
A geriatric I know told me all about.
Let me get this straight, Aunt Amanda. You promised Helen that you would take care of Jerry?
Yes, a solemn promise, and a promise I intend to keep.
Now look, Amanda, I think you must have misunderstood. An easy thing to do over coffee. Helen probably meant that you should stay for just a few days. And Mark and Shirley have been doing just that. So it looks as if you've had a wasted journey.
No, Jerry.
No?
No, not just for a few days. For the rest of your life.
The rest of my life?
I don't believe in half measures, Jerry. In fact, I've already put my house on the market.
I might as well join Helen now. It would make it easier for the grave diggers to store that stool damn bit loose.
I'll get you another drink.
Good idea. Don't I have any say in the matter?
No. Of course not. Helen and I knew you wouldn't be in a fit state to make decisions. So we made this one for you.
Yeah, I know. And I don't want to appear ungrateful. But really, I'd rather be here on my own.
You may think that, Jerry, but under the stress of what's happened, you're not in a position to know what's good for you.
I do know what's good for me.
Whiskey.
Exactly.
You see, Jerry dear, at the moment you're not thinking straight. That's only natural, but you'll soon get used to the idea.
I don't want to get used to the idea. Anyway, I'm afraid it's out of the question.
Why?
Because I've already agreed to go and live with Shirley and Mark.
What on earth for?
Because they asked me before you arrived, didn't you, Shirley?
Yes, we certainly did.
And what did you say?
I said, yes, of course. Didn't I, Mom?
Yes.
Why on earth did you say that?
Because I want to go and stay with Shirley. She's my daughter and I'm all alone. And I want to go and live with my daughter and her family.
Don't be ridiculous. You'd be in the way.
No, I wouldn't. I get along very well with the boys. Don't I, Mark?
Yes, definitely.
You can talk sports to them, can't you, Dad?
Yeah, I know all about basketball.
And football.
And definitely football.
And you always watch the America's Cup.
Yes, I do. Every month.
Every year.
So that's that, I'm afraid, Amanda. I'm moving in with them tomorrow. It's all arranged.
That's before you knew that I was coming.
Oh, yeah. But I promised, you see, you can't break a promise.
Nonsense. Of course you can. You won't be on your own now. I'm here, so you can cancel the agreement. I'm sure they'll understand.
No, we won't.
And we've already told the boys he's coming now.
Oh, good. So there we are. I'm going to live with Shirley and Mark, and that's that.
Don't be silly, Jerry. It wouldn't work. I know what you're like. Helen told me all about you.
Over a cup of coffee?
For one thing, she said you're a man who likes lists. I knew it. And I'll bet Shirley never made a list in her life.
I wouldn't mind starting.
Yes, you would. It's out of the question. You're staying here with me, Jerry, and that's that. Be a dear and carry my suitcases upstairs, will you, Mark? You'll be much better off with me, Jerry.
Will I?
We'll be able to have long conversations at the fireplace and sipping malt whiskey.
There isn't any malt.
There is now. I brought some with me. Mark, please be careful. Those suitcases cost a fortune. Be careful.
Well, what a surprise.
Yes, it was a surprise. I thought surprises were supposed to be fun. Never mind, Daddy.
Whatever makes you think that?
Never mind, Daddy. Perhaps it's all for the best.
Jerry!
Can I help you? Are you looking for someone?
Not any longer.
Good heavens, it's you!
Yes.
Isabel, how nice to see you.
It took a long time for you to recognize me. It wasn't very flattering. Have I grown so old and ugly?
No, never. I'm just not used to people entering without ringing. I guess the door was left open. You took me by surprise.
I'm so sorry.
I'm delighted to see you.
I meant about Helen.
Oh, yeah. You heard that.
I read about it in the paper. I was so sad for you.
Thanks. I should have let you know, but...
Don't worry. I understood. I just thought I'd drive over and see if there was anything I could do to help.
You haven't brought two suitcases, have you?
Good heavens, no. Why should I do that?
Never mind. Come here. It's good to see you. Help yourself to a drink if you'd like.
Thank you.
You haven't changed a bit.
It's too late to say that now.
It must be years since Helen and I saw you.
Yes, time races by at our age, doesn't it?
Yes, I find that a week only lasts 3 days.
Cheers.
I'm sorry.
How was it?
The flowers were lovely. The pastor was terrible. It was quite obvious that he had never met her.
And how is Shirley?
Oh, she's fine. A tower of strength, actually. She and her husband have been staying with me since Ellen died.
I needn't have worried then. You're being looked after.
Yes, but I'm glad to see you. You need old friends at a time like this. How about you? Are you still married?
To which one?
Don't tell me you've had more than one since you divorced Alan.
Oh, two at last count.
Are you still married to either of them?
Oh, I'm afraid not.
What happened?
I gave them both the boot.
Why?
They didn't live up to expectations.
What went wrong?
In every department. So now I'm a free woman.
No boy toy on the horizon?
Not yet, but I'm keeping my eyes open. Where's Shirley hiding herself? Is he closeted in the kitchen?
Oh, no, no. She's upstairs with, oh, good heavens. For a moment, they forgot all about her.
Forgotten all about who?
Oh, sorry. I didn't know we had company.
Isabel didn't ring the front door bell because the door was open.
Oh, I see. Right. Jerry?
Oh, yes, I'm sorry. This is Mark, Shirley's husband.
Oh, you're spoken for. What a pity. I thought my boy toy had arrived.
Haven't you two met before?
No, I wasn't invited to the wedding, remember? I'm sure I would have remembered you. Hello, Mark.
Do you have a name?
Yes, my parents gave me one of those when I was born. I'm waiting to see if Jerry's going to tell you what it is.
Why, is it a secret?
I'm not sure.
Oh, sorry. This is Isabel French. Helen and I knew Isabella millions of years ago.
She doesn't look too bad for a million-year-old lady.
Why, thank you, Mark.
Isabel kindly drove over to express her condolences.
Ah, I thought I hadn't seen you at the funeral.
No, I'm afraid I wasn't there. Was I, Jerry?
You weren't in Tanzania by any chance, were you?
I don't even know where that is.
It was my fault. I misled Isabel's address.
Can I freshen your drink up a little?
Oh, I think you can.
What was it? Gin?
Oh, gin, yes. Thank you.
You don't want another one, do you?
Well, I've only had one.
But you'll be driving home soon.
Will I?
You must supply her with drinks, Mark, not when she's driving.
I didn't know she was driving. She just got here, didn't she?
So did I.
Make it a small one, Mark.
Not okay. Too small, Mark.
I'll just make it a small one. So not one not too small gin coming up.
Is everything all right, Jerry?
Yeah, I think so.
I thought you said you were pleased to see an old friend at a time like this.
Yes, I was. I am.
Just gin, right?
Thank you, Mark. I like your son-in-law already.
You remember how long it's been since we've seen each other?
Oh, a few years. We do seem to have been drifted apart a little.
You live quite far away.
Hadn't you better be on your way?
I just got here.
Have you kept in touch with her? Kept in touch with her? She's not going to leave now. She just arrived. You've got all those years to catch up on. And you said yourself that she shouldn't drive when she'd been drinking. So you better stay the night.
She can't do that.
Of course she can. She doesn't want to go rushing off when she just arrived. You can stay, can't you?
Well, I suppose so.
No, she can't. There isn't any room.
Of course there's room. She can stay in the spare room.
I haven't got a spare room.
You've got five bedrooms.
I use one as a study.
Well, that still leaves four. That's settled then. So you're staying tonight.
Don't you want me to stay, Jerry?
Of course he does. And Shirley would be delighted. She's cooking a big meal tonight, and there's plenty to go around.
Mom, had you better go in the kitchen and see how Shirley's getting on in there?
I thought Shirley was seeing to that.
Well, she can't see to it alone, can she?
Can she?
Please, go and see how she's getting on.
But Shirley's upstairs.
Well, there's something in the kitchen you can sort out on your own, isn't there? Listen, I want to have a word with Isabel.
Ah, that's more like it, Jerry. And it's about time, too. I'll leave you two alone so that you can catch up on old times, and I'll go sort something out in the kitchen.
Are you sure you're all right?
Yes, I think so. Why?
You seem very anxious to get rid of me all of a sudden. I thought we were going to have a nice chat about the old days.
Yes, we were.
Mark and Shirley will think it very strange if I go shooting off when I've only just arrived.
Well, I guess they might.
If there's a problem about me staying the night, I can easily book a hotel.
Oh, good idea. There's one just down the road. You can stay there and drive home first thing in the morning.
Jerry! Go without saying hello to Shirley. Whatever is she doing upstairs all this time?
Well, that's the trouble. There's somebody up there with her.
Oh, I see. She's got a friend staying. That's why you were worried about the sleeping arrangements. Well, aren't I allowed to meet this friend of hers?
That's not a friend of hers.
Who is it then, Jerry?
It's nobody you want to meet.
How do you know?
Because I know who it is, and it's nobody you want to meet.
I might.
You won't.
Why not?
Because she's a person who likes asking questions, likes poking her nose into things.
Oh, and you think she might ask me questions?
I'm certain of it.
How can you be certain?
Because she's my sister-in-law.
Amanda?
Yes, did you ever meet her?
Oh, God, no, I don't think so.
You'd remember if you had, and I don't want her cornering you and giving you the third degree.
You mean she might start asking me questions about Alan and why we broke up and all?
Yeah, I think she was suspicious at the time, and you might get upset all over again. I don't want that, not when you were kind enough to call with your condolences.
Oh, fancy you were thinking of that.
And that's why I didn't want you to stay and sleep in the spare room.
Oh, Jerry, you are so kind.
You know, there was nothing to sort out in the kitchen.
I'm sorry, I didn't know anyone was here.
I'll go and tell her that Isabel is here.
So you.
Isabel's not staying, Carol?
You remember Isabel, darling? Do you remember Isabel, darling?
I do remember Isabel. I didn't know anyone was here, though.
Isn't it good to see you?
You must stay for dinner.
Please.
Hey,
Jerry, Isabel French didn't come all this way for smoked salmon sandwiches.
Isabel's not staying for dinner. You've only catered for three, and there are four of us already. It's a stew.
No, it's not a stew. It's a casserole.
Come along, Isabel. I'll take you into the dining room.
Why?
I know it's unusual, but that's where we keep the telephone. And then you can call the hotel down the road and book a room for the night. And I'm sure you'll get a decent dinner there.
Well, she may have been married then. Doesn't mean she's still married. She could be divorced, for all we know. And now she's on the lookout for a replacement.
Don't be crazy. Mommy's only been buried a week.
Why, you can't hang around, you know, when you're a divorcee.
Mark.
I tell you what, though, families gotta stick together. So if Jerry wants to keep Isabella's secret, that's his business. And we've gotta back him up.
What are you talking about now?
If Amanda starts asking questions about Isabel, we'll have to cover for her.
Cover for him?
Yes, we mustn't let Amanda know that Isabel has got her feet under the table.
If anyone's got their feet under the table, it's Amanda. She's already moved in, and with two suitcases.
Yeah. Hey, you don't suppose that Amanda is thinking of making a move on Jerry as well, do you?
No, of course not. He's her brother-in-law.
Well, you never know about these old people.
Isn't it rather unseemly to have such hilarity in a house of mourning?
Yes, of course. Sorry, Aunt Amanda.
It's just nerves. Yes. We're all nervous, you know, about what's going on.
She's changed.
Has she? Good heavens, she has.
I felt rather overdressed with Jerry in that frightful vest.
What's ever going on in the dining room? Jerry's in the dining room with a strange woman.
What? What did you say?
Are you deaf all of a sudden?
I have my hearing aid.
You mean you didn't recognize
her?
I
have never seen her before in my life.
Oh, good.
What are they doing in the dining room?
Did she want to borrow Jerry's
telephone? That's right.
To report them.
Yeah, she wanted to borrow Jerry's telephone.
Borrowing Jerry? That's a funny place to keep a telephone in the dining room.
Yeah, I know. But at any rate, she had to borrow his phone to report the fault.
It's no good. They can't help us. Thought you were upstairs. Dinner isn't ready yet.
I couldn't stay up there forever. Did you ring the phone company?
Sorry?
I presume you are with Verizon. They're usually very good at an emergency.
Why emergency?
They were all booked up.
Don't be ridiculous. They can't all be booked up.
What?
Does that mean you will stay for dinner?
I'm not sure.
She came to borrow the telephone, and now she's staying for dinner.
Why should she want to borrow a telephone?
How long have you been out of order then?
Sorry?
You did come to borrow Jerry's.
She was out of order about 3 hours. You see, she was in an important conversation with somebody in Trenton, and suddenly, line went dead.
What are you talking about?
Of course, I always stick to Verizon myself. As far as I'm concerned, cell phones are totally out of the question.
What exactly is it I was going to borrow from Jerry?
His telephone, of course. Why else would you both be in the dining room?
Sorry?
That was why you were in the dining room, wasn't it? To use the telephone?
Well, yes, but...
Because her telephone is out of order?
It's not, is it?
Of course it is.
Oh, I didn't know.
That was why you came here, to use the phone.
I think we better go and see to the stew.
Why do you keep calling it a stew? It's a casserole!
I don't understand why you had to drive somewhere to borrow a telephone. Haven't you got neighbors where you live?
But I didn't come here to borrow the telephone.
You didn't?
No!
Are you sure?
What?
Well, I suppose you might have come to borrow the telephone.
I thought I was visiting.
Why not?
Mark said you did.
Did he?
And if you didn't come here to borrow the telephone, what did you come here for?
To see Jerry.
To see Jerry? Then why did Mark tell me that tale about the telephone?
I can't imagine.
Well then, Jerry, aren't you going to introduce me to your... visitor?
Oh, yes, of course. I'm sorry. This is Isabel French.
Ah, so you're Isabel French.
She's an old friend of ours.
Yes, I've heard all about her. Have you?
She came to offer her condolences.
And do you always receive condolences in the dining room?
Sorry?
You were both in the dining room.
Oh, yeah. I was telephoning the hotel down the road because Isabel needs a room.
You don't live around here then?
No, not anymore. It's a bit of a drive now that Jerry's given me a couple of gins.
Only very small ones.
I see, and there's no room at the inn.
No, they're fully booked.
Then Isabel must stay here.
She can't.
Of course she can. She must. She certainly mustn't drive after gin, even very small ones.
So, you're Helen's sister.
So how did you know who I was when I didn't know who you were?
Oh, Jerry told me you were upstairs.
Then he should have told me that you were downstairs. I was changing for dinner.
Good heavens, so you were.
Well, I felt the somber suit was a little out of place as you seemed to be dressed so loudly. I hope you weren't thinking of packing her off to a hotel without introducing us.
No, no, of course not.
So that's settled. Isabel's staying for dinner.
There's not enough food.
There's always enough. I've had Shirley's casseroles before, and there's always enough.
No, I really can't stay.
Of course you can.
I'd really rather drive home before it gets too dark.
There's no question of you driving home now that Jerry's been plying you with gin. Not only must you stay for dinner, but you must stay the night here as well. She must stay the night as well, mustn't she, Jerry?
Well, actually, I don't think...
No, I couldn't, really.
Jerry insists, don't you, Jerry?
Do I?
Of course you do, and more importantly, so do I.
Come along, everybody. Dinner's ready.
Yes, dinner's ready.
How lovely. Come along, Isabel. You're going to sit next to me at dinner, and you don't have to worry about Isabel driving home because it's all been settled. She's going to stay here for the night.